because it's quite a big tourist town, you get a lot of people who are put off from coming as soon as they hear that there are floods. There had been proposals for building walls which had eventually got thrown out on the cost-benefit analysis that the Environment Agency carry out, where they said, there's nothing we can do for you unless somebody comes up with some good ideas. And in the civic society, we were looking at it and saying, what could we do? And somebody had come up with this idea of an upstream bund, where you just held the water temporarily upstream behind a small dam. The problem there is that how do you get people to listen to you when you're just Mr. Nobody from Pickering? But then along came the universities and said, would you like to work with us on a study? You end up with a report, and then you've got that credibility that they're backing. If you mention Oxford University, people tend to prick up their ears.
We put together a project which had a number of fairly standard dimensions about trying to improve the way in which we model flood risk and manage flood risk. But the experimental dimension was to work with communities actually affected by flooding in the UK and to get their local knowledge and perspectives integrated into the modelling process. Having invented this method of doing it, we had to try it out, and Pickering was our first attempt. With hindsight, it's a very successful project, but at the time, we didn't know it was going to be successful. We were trying it out in that sense of experiment too. When we first actually went to Pickering, we were really feeling quite nervous about it because we turned up the week after these unseasonal summer floods. We might have looked like vultures, in which case we thought, crikey, we might not get a very good response. Or it would raise the issue again in people's minds and there would be an enthusiasm for people to volunteer. It turned out to be the latter, so we were very fortunate in that regard. It's an excellent way of working where the flood management authorities no longer has the confidence of the local population.
Once we got past the stage of, you know, we'd finished the project and trying to get it further, I'm just sort of poking and prodding at various agencies, MPs, local councillors and so on. But at the end of it, we've got a flood scheme. As it happened, DEFRA had a pot of money and they were looking for a number of projects in a similar way to this as pilot projects. And we ended up winning the bid for one of three of those. We're now in 2014 and it's just coming to fruition. Under normal conditions, you've got a culvert going through this big concrete structure, which will be underground. The water all runs through the culvert, carries on through Pickering, no problem. Then you get the heavy rainfall events. When it gets to the point where the amount of water in the beck can no longer get through that culvert, the water will start to back up, fills the floodplain. What it provides is 90% of the amount of water storage needed in case of a 1 in 25 flood. You come back here in a year's time and you'll be astounded at the difference as it greens over, the trees start to regenerate and they'll be replanted. They were always speaking at our level. They weren't trying to do this highbrow rubbish and we're clever and they're not.
So we've produced a large number of papers, but they pale into insignificance in comparison with actually making a difference to flood risk management